Hey guys, welcome back to the show. Get your notepad and your pen out, all right? Because you're going to want to take notes, all right? The vagus nerve is a major nerve in the human body. It helps regulate various body functions, and right now it's trending.
Oh, it's so hot right now. The hashtag vagus nerve stimulation has been viewed over 55 million times on TikTok. Here to help us learn more, we have our favorite yoga and meditation teacher, Kelly Smith. She calms us down just right when she walks into the room.
I know. I feel like my vagus nerve has been stimulated.
Yeah. Oh my God. Well, that's what I'm here for.
Okay, what is it though? Because I mean, I've actually like listened to podcasts about it. I've been hearing people talk about it, and I still don't quite get the mechanics of it all.
Yeah, so it's a cranial nerve. It's actually our 10th cranial nerve. We have 12 of them. Mm. And think of it as the connector between like your mind and your gut. So it is this long nerve that starts in your brain, cranial, like the brain, and it goes all the way down through past your throat. We're gonna talk about that, and ends in your intestines. So it's really like the mind-body connector. That's why it's so important.
Oh my gosh.
So is that the one that's actually like responsible for appetite control and like telling your body when you're full or?
So it has more to do with like your nervous system. So okay. You know how they sometimes talk about like your gut brain or like I feel it in my gut?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This idea of like sometimes you can really have this like visceral like feeling in your body, but it's also like connected to your brain.
So like if you're really stressed out and then you get a stomach ache, is that sort of the idea?
Like the butterflies in the stomach.
Yeah, precisely. And it helps with like your autonomic nervous system. So it also has to do with like the feedback loop of telling you about like temperature and like what's happening in your gut and in your body. And it kind of creates this communication from brain to body, body to brain. And it helps the two talk to each other.
Okay. Another thing I'm kind of concerned, or I'm not really concerned, I feel okay, but I'm confused about is this vagal tone.
Okay. Yeah.
So what is it singing? Like what's it doing?
Okay. So think of vagal tone as like tone of a muscle.
Okay.
And so the more vagal tone that you have, think of it as like that's how strong your vagal nerve is. And higher vagal tone usually means like better stress resilience. It means that you're able to like cope with stressful things. And the more that you activate or stimulate your vagus nerve, the stronger it'll get or the more tone it will get. Just like if I wanted stronger biceps,
right,
I would activate them more and it would become stronger and more toned.
But you're not like seeing the nerve.
Yeah, so how do you know if you've got a strong or a weak tone?
So really you're going to basically look at how do I respond to stress.
Oh, okay.
So do the great little things really get me going and it's hard. Like if you don't feel like you can ever go from that fight or flight back to like your default mode, chances are we have low vagal tone. And so the more that we work on it, we'll be able to go from that activated state to more of what I call like our default state.
Because I would like to go to that state faster. Like I would like to not feel like my heart pumping if I like wake up in the middle of the night or if I have like a stressful situation going on.
Yeah. So maybe the vagus nerve is your thing.
Oh, this could be my hot new thing.
You can add it to your self-care routine.
I will.
Yours is so good.
I'm trying.
It is.
All right. So then what can we do? If you are feeling like this is we're speaking directly to this person, you're like, oh my gosh, I feel like I'm pretty weak in my vagal tones.
No shame in that game.
No shame in that game. How do we strengthen it? Our exercises. What do we need to do?
Yeah, and you know what? It's so easy. So basically, there's a few different things you can do, even like humming and singing. You're driving in the car, singing in the shower, stuff like that. Because remember, it goes from your brain to your gut, but it moves through. It's a bilateral nerve, so it goes right through your throat on both sides. So any
music.
Kind of
music.
Really?
Yeah, so singing, humming. Also, you can take your hands and do this little kind of like gentle,
like
a few fingers in front of the ear and behind.
Oh.
Helps. Also, this fun thing helps to reset it. You take your hands behind your head like this.
Okay.
And then you look forward. Open up the elbows. You're going to look all the way over to one side, but don't move your head. And you're just going to look to one side until you yawn. And then that, like, yawn with the eye movement helps to reset and stimulate the vagus nerve. So you do that for, like, 30 seconds. You'll yawn. And then go the other way.
So you naturally will just yawn by doing that?
Yeah, you'll do it. Everyone, if you're at home, try it.
That is crazy.
It takes, like, 30 seconds. Then you'll yawn. And you'll kind of feel this instant just, like, it's almost like a little pressure relief.
Yeah.
And then deep breathing, I mean, doesn't that help everything?
Always
but like
so
an
good
inhale through the nose and a loud exhale through the mouth, like, so again, think like throat stuff, because that's where it's most easily activated, because it's really close to the surface of the throat.
Do you think you have to do the holding of the breath? Because I feel like I don't like that part that much.
When I don't think
breathe
you need
in,
to do
and
that.
Then it's that box breathing, you know, where you like breathe in,
too.
And then you hold it, and then I'm kind of like, I need some air, and then...
I think let that one go. I think in particular for the vagal tone, the maybe like an inhale for four and then a long exhale of the mouth for like six or seven.
Okay.
I think that one's going to be more your jam, and it's going to be better for vagal nerve.
Massage and acupressure helps too.
Yes, absolutely. So you can kind of do a little bit of kind of neck work here, even light little tapping.
I'm telling you, I have one of those acupressure mats and I am obsessed with it. I lay on it and I really do feel better.
Well, even like, have you ever seen like a gua sha?
Yeah.
What's a gua sha?
It's like a stone, and it's a Chinese practice of of like kind of massaging your face.
Yeah, it's meant for lymphatic drainage.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But you can use it like on your neck, and it'll help clear it and activate your
vagus. Oh, yeah, it's
nerve,
like those
too.
Little smooth kind of like curved like rocks or stones.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Yeah, they're super cool.
And so all of this stuff, does it help to do it yourself? Like, does your own physical touch help this process versus maybe going to somebody, a clinician or somebody, and
no,
having
it's
them
DIY.
Do this? It's all DIY.
DIY.
Yeah.
Deep breathing, of course, I mean, meditation and deep breathing helps everything, but like a little bit of throat stimulation, singing, humming, big deep breaths, all that little kind of reset thing.
That's really
it
cool.
It all helps, and it's so, so easy, but it makes a huge difference.
Okay, before we go, what do you think about the idea of a club in Las Vegas called the Vegas Nerve?
Okay, I love a play on words.
All right, all right. Good. Okay. Spelled differently.
Okay, you guys, if you think that your vagal tones are a little weak, we've got the answer for you right here.
They're really
all
good.
Right. So Kelly has an episode of her podcast, Mindful in Minutes, that is a vagus nerve guided meditation.
Ooh.
It's just 15 minutes, you guys. It's specifically targeted towards stimulating your vagus nerve and calming your nervous system before the club.
I'm going to download that one in the break. We posted a link at TwinCitiesLive.com. Maybe the music she means is like,
it's kind of hard to hum like that. You guys will figure it out. This takes practice.